Hello, world. Hello to the world out there. My name is Linda. I'm not going to say my last name because it's slightly recognizable, but I need to go on record and say I'm very unhappy with the service at the Red Lobster I recently received. So let me give you the backstory. My husband is a very well-known celebrity. I'm not going to say his name because I don't want this to be a video about the bride of a famous person complaining, but that's what I'm doing, but I'm going to leave his name out. So Frank and I had the night off together, which is very unusual this time of year because at this time of year, late October, my husband is very busy. He's got a lot of personal appearances and the such, but we had the night off and we wanted to make a date of it. So we said, let's go to the Red Lobster for some endless shrimp and some Cheddar Bay biscuits. So we go to the Red Lobster, fine and dandy. Our hostess, Amanda, takes us to a table and she puts us at a booth. And I say, no, I don't think this is going to work, Amanda. Let me tell you why. My husband is 7 feet 9 inches tall, okay? He's not going to be comfortable in a booth. And Amanda tells me, I'm sorry, but this booth is the next table in rotation. What? Rotation? I know not of this rotation. I say, Amanda, I hear you, but I don't understand. All I know is I see some empty tables over there and my husband and I would like to sit at an empty table instead of this tiny little booth. Well, again, she says, sorry, that's the rotation, and she drops the menus and walks away. No. No. Bad, bad customer service, Red Lobster. I said, you know what? Let's make the most of it, Frankie. It's fine. So my husband squeezes into the booth. I sit down. There's a lady directly behind me, and my hair is hitting her in the back of the head. And I said, you know what? I'm not comfortable. So we call Amanda over, and we ask to speak to a manager. Now, this is when Bobby shows up. Now, first off, when Bobby shows up to the table, he is visibly startled by the appearance of my husband. Rude. Granted, my husband is 7 feet 9 inches tall, has green skin, a flat forehead, and a big scar on his face, but that's the way he was made. He can't help it. You should never react to someone's appearance that way, Bobby. Just you should know that. That's very rude. I say, Bobby, this table is not going to work for us. We're very uncomfortable. We would like to sit at this other empty table over there. He says, I guess I can help you. Like he's doing me a huge favor, right? So finally, he takes us to another table, and he puts us at a table right next to the toilet. I say, Bobby, we just passed 5 tables that were empty. We can't sit over there. And he says, no, this table, the one by the toilet, is not counted in the rotation. Again, with a rotation. Like, I know what a rotation is. I say, Bobby, you expect me to sit here and have all-you-can-eat shrimp and Cheddar Bay biscuits as I'm walking people, watching people walk in and out of the loo? No, that's not going to do. And he tells me, you can either sit at this table or you can go home. I say, oh, you're going to make my husband very angry. And believe me, you don't want to see my husband angry. Fires involved, pitchforks, it's never pretty. But Bobby says, take it or leave it. I say, you know what? I've got a hankering for some Cheddar Bay biscuits. We'll take the table by the toilet. So, everything is fine with the exception of the people coming in and out of the bathroom all night. The Cheddar Bay biscuits were great. My cocktail was delicious. I had a chocolate dessert. My server, Missy, was wonderful. She never missed a beat. Always had the Cheddar Bay biscuits, the endless shrimp coming. By the way, my husband, Frank, he had a new record, 227 shrimp. Way to go, Frankie. I love him. So when the check comes, Missy hands me the check, and I look it over, and I'm shocked, I tell you, absolutely shocked to see that they charged us for every single thing on that we had eaten. I say, what? You didn't even comp us like a dessert or a drink or something for all of this horrible customer service we've received? And Missy, bless her heart, says, I know, I tried to get them to do it, but they wouldn't do it. I say, but that's so unfair. We just come here for some nice dinner. We don't even get anything for free, even though you were treating us like horrible, like my husband's a monster. And Missy, as sweet as she is, touches my hand and says, I'm really sorry. Well, you know, Missy was adorable, but I'm sorry we couldn't tip you, Missy, but I'm sure you understand. You know, if we're going to have some terrible service from Bobby and Amanda, I'm sorry, we just can't tip you, Missy. So that's how it goes sometimes in the restaurant world. So I wanted to go on record right here on this video and let everyone know that I, Linda Frankenstein, Linda F., and my husband Frankie, will never be going to the Red Lobster again. 1 star, Red Lobster, 1 star, because you treated me and my husband with such disrespect. I think that's all I need to say. So, happy Halloween. It's my favorite time of year. And Sorry, Red Lobster, but you lost this customer forever. Okay, Frankie, I did it. Frankie, I did it.